reached the net. Jacob Trouba to the Rangers for Neil Pionk and a first-round pick in the 2019 draft. The 25-year-old had 8 goals, 50 points, 82 games this season with the Jets. We dive into it now. What are the Rangers getting?
They're getting an absolute top-pairing defenseman. I mean, a number one pair right shot defenseman. That might be the hardest thing to find in the NHL. He is very good defensively, elite level shutdown guy, but also underrated offensively. You saw the 50 points that he put up with Winnipeg. He can get it done, and he does that as a right shot who plays in the same team as Dustin Byfuglien. So it's not like he gets all the offensive situations that a right shot guy would get. A very good, underrated, top pairing defenseman. Really nice pickup as far as on the ice. He can play against any situation and any opponent and get the job done. He'll be a big addition for the Rangers.
Yeah, I completely agree with you. He's one of the guys that you only really can get if you have a top 10 draft pick, really. And the Rangers, they had that run of they were a very good team, went to the final one year, were always in the mix. What were they doing? They were trading away draft picks, and they weren't drafting high even if they kept them. So now they're in this rebuild. They make this move, and they bring in Jacob Trouba, who, as you say, a legit right shot, top pair defender, plays in all situations. Now, he had those 50 points. Winnipeg has a lot more offensive juice around him.
Sure.
So that might play into it. And also, Byfuglien was out, remember, for a long stretch last year. So we'll see how he does. I think there's offense there, so we'll see how much offense it is. But this Ranger defense is going to look a lot different. And Trouba's paired, at least here, in the projected D pairs with his buddy Brady Shea, who he knows very well. Mm-hmm. Rangers remaking their defense as part of this rebuild. It'll be interesting to see how they look when it's all finished at the end of it, because I think there's more moves
to be
for
made.
The Rangers to make here.
And it's also worth noting, so if he's so good, why is Winnipeg getting rid of him?
That's what I was going to ask you. What's the deal there?
And I think it's been widely reported that Jacob Trouba's fiance has a degree in medicine, in the medical field in some capacity, and she's not able to work in Canada because of the licensing and the citizenship and everything else. So there was a few markets that he wanted to go to. So for the Winnipeg Jets, maybe the return on the deal doesn't look like as much as it should be, but I don't think there was a big market for Kevin Cheveldayoff to work with. I think Jacob Trouba said, you can trade me wherever you want. I mean, that's your, you know, I have one more year of controlled service for a team. So you can trade me to any team in the league you want. But just know that I'm going to pick my destination with regards to my family and my situation going forward where everyone can pursue their careers. And how are we going to question that?
Can't.
For a guy to come out and say, you know what, my wife or my fiance's for him, his career is as important as mine, and and she wants to be happy, and she deserves to chase her dream and her education and all the rest of it. It's a great, strong move by Jacob Trouba to take that stance. But that's why I think Kevin Cheveldayoff was a little bit hamstrung in that he didn't have 24 American teams that he could trade Jacob Trouba to. I think he had two or three
couple that
he wanted to go to and sign an extension with and pursue his career, and so that Winnipeg could try to max the return knowing that he was not going to be just a one-year rental. So you need to factor that in when you realize the first-round pick returning, which is what Winnipeg gave for Kevin Hayes, back to Winnipeg, their original, and then Neil Pionk as well.
Yeah, and for Winnipeg, from their end of it, like you say, they probably didn't have a lot to choose from here because Jacob had a lot of control over the situation. What they get is they get that first-round pick back, which is important for Winnipeg to have a first-round pick, so they get that back.
They loaned it to the Rangers for a
couple
months.
They loaned it to him for Kevin Hayes, right? And then and they also get a player in Neil Pionk who is a right-shot defenseman, offensive-minded kid. He can skate well, doesn't defend very well, but you could plug him in the back end of your group there in Winnipeg, and he fits the kind of game they want to play. They want to play with speed. And so for Winnipeg, this is the return. But really, for the Rangers, they get a great player.
Yeah, and for Pionk, the concern is he's a right shot, great.
Yeah.
He's very good in the power play, also really nice. They have Dustin Byfuglien as a right shot, good in the power play guy. So you're right, he doesn't defend his own blue line very well. That's really where he struggles. He just can't hold his own blue line. Guy's able to skate the puck in his own end. That will be something he needs to improve on if he wants to be a contributor in Winnipeg. Because Winnipeg's making some changes now.
Yeah. And they have some other things they have to do.
And they're a Stanley Cup contending team. They still want to maintain that status as a Stanley Cup contending team. They're taking a pretty big piece in Jacob Trouba away. Tyler Myers pending UFA. Who knows what their right side will look like now with Byfuglien, Pionk, and others as they go along.
That's the league we live in now, right?
Yeah.
That's the world we live in where things can be changing. Your window to be
successful. Your window tight.
And like, you know, with San Jose making the big move to keep Carlson yesterday, it's a long contract. But I think they're looking at a small window where they think they can succeed. They're willing to pay that price to try to win the Stanley Cup. We'll see if it works out for them. But in the end, for the Rangers, they get a great player.